Do you want to update information that already lives inside of SmartSuite, but you want to change it, fix it inside of an automation? Well, if so, this is the video for you because we are going to break down how you can find and update information in SmartSuite per your automation needs. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Of course, SmartSuite is at the forefront of our favorite tools inside of no-code, perfect for managing any information, getting organized and automated. It's at the heart of what SmartSuite does. Now, in this video, as I mentioned, we're going to break down how you can find and update records inside of SmartSuite automation. But before we get into it, I want to invite you to follow along with me inside of your own SmartSuite account. Now, of course, if you're already a SmartSuite user, simply open it up and you can just follow along step by step. But if you have not yet signed up for SmartSuite, please consider using our link below this video. Yes, it's an affiliate link, and yes, we will get a little bit of credit for having brought you onto the product, but more importantly, you will be eligible for some exclusive SmartSuite swag if and when you choose to update your account. So if you want that exclusive SmartSuite swag, then make sure that you use our link below to be eligible for that. Now let's go ahead and hop on into the example here and get on into it. So what I have on my screen is a very simple SmartSuite solution. It's called Update with Automation. Two simple apps here. I've got just a title number going on down, and I'm just counting these different records. And then I have a checkbox. Nothing too fancy here. And I might check some of these boxes off throughout the day, but what I want is an automation that's going to, when I tell it to, look, find all of the boxes that are checked, and erase them. Just get rid of them. Undo all those checkboxes. How can we build this? Well, it's pretty simple thanks to the new find and update features inside of SmartSuite automations. Now, first, what I'm going to do is build us a trigger. I can do this in the same app if I want to, or I can do it in a different application inside of this solution. So swinging on to application 2 here, you'll see I've got just a simple record. It's called automation trigger, and I've got two different outputs on my single select field. Don't do it or do it. I feel like this is a Shia LaBeouf. Is that how you say that guy's name? Shia LaBeouf? I don't know. But yeah, he did that whole do it thing. Anyway, let's choose the don't do it because we don't want our automation to trigger just yet. But the idea is when we are ready, we're going to go down and say do it. That's going to trigger the automation. And then, of course, at the end of the automation, we need to update that trigger and return it to its previous status of don't do it. All right. So how do we build this automation? Let's swing on up to our automation at the top of our solution and come down to automations. Inside here, we can choose our trigger, and we are going to go with a record matches a condition. And of course, that is the record in app 2. And the automation trigger is the field that we're looking for there. And it must be equal to do it. Once that occurs, that's what we want to trigger this automation. What's the automation going to do? Well, the first thing we need to do is change this back to don't do it. How can we do that? Can we update records? Yes, we can. We can update records, but note that in order to select the records to update, we must update either a triggering record or a set of records returned by the find records action. So note that we have two options here. We can update the triggering record, which is what we want to do in this case, and or we can update after we first sought out a set of records as returned by the find records action. So we're gonna do both of these, but right now, this is the easy one. We're just gonna update the trigger. We set that thing to say do it, and we're gonna change it to be don't do it. So no problem there. We are selecting the trigger here, and we are going to update what field? Well, again, we called it the trigger. Automation trigger is the field name, and we want to make sure that this gets switched back to the other field value. And of course, that field value is don't do it. So remember, the original one is the trigger is do it. We want to then revert back to don't do it because, of course, the automation will already be underway. What's the rest of the automation, though? We have to go and find all those checked boxes in app 1 and then uncheck them. How can we do it? Well, let's add an action. As we already mentioned, we have to first perform the find function. We have to find the records before we can update them. So let's find them. Find these records, and of course we're asked to tell it what solution the records live in. In our case, we're all in the same solution here. But do note that you can have automations that are firing and performing actions across all the solutions inside of your SmartSuite workspace. So here we are inside of our update with automation solution, but the app is not app two. App two we use to trigger. App one is where the records live with the checked boxes. So we're looking inside of app one, and what are we doing? Of course, we can name this. We might say search for checked boxes, and then we have to apply our condition or conditions. So in our case, our condition is that the checked box or checkbox is equal to yes. That is, it's checked. So whatever your conditions are that you want to perform on your find, go ahead and enter them at this point. Now, you also notice that we have an advanced modal down below. And by selecting this, we now see that we can limit the number of records that we bring back. So in the case where you might be wanting to update a record, a singular record, you can change this number to only be one so that you don't accidentally update multiple things. You can also sort the records that you find by a particular feature inside of here. So if you want to focus on a particular field, like the date created, for example, you could say, I want to update only one record, but the record I want to update is the one that matches this condition that was created the earliest or created the most recently. So in that way, you can establish not only how many records you're going to return, but also which of those records you're going to actually be activating on based on the sort that you put together here. Okay, so now that we've got the rules out of the way, we find our records. What do we want to do to them? We want to erase that checkbox. So now we can go again to update records. Now that we're all built up, you'll see that we have, again, solution. Now, number two, app. Well, in this case, we want to go to app one. That's where the records live that we're updating. And as soon as we do that, of course, SmartSuite is smart enough to know that the action that we're going to be performing on must be the search that we performed in the previous step of our automation. So of course, if you had multiple different searches inside of your automation sequence, you would be able to choose the right one here. But in our case, we only have one particular search that's impacting app one, which is the app we've selected here. So there it is. We find those records with the checked box and we want to update them all at once. What are we going to do? Well, all we need to do is take that checked box and mark it to no. So we have the option here to either update this with fields from trigger. So if we had data in the trigger that we wanted to use in this step of the automation, we could do that. We could also take something from our previous step where we searched for the checked boxes. Of course, that's not very helpful in this case. But lastly, we have the field values option. So this checkbox is either yes or no. We've already found all of those that have a yes, and we just want to update them to be a no. Quite simple. Once we're done with this, of course, we can name our automation. Don't be lazy here because you want to stay organized. For the sake of this example, I will just move on, add the automation, and switch it on. Let's take it out for a test. So, flipping out of our automation panel, I'm going to look back at app one, make sure that I've got some checked boxes. All right, I've got a couple checked boxes. It looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and move on and trigger the automation. I go into app two and I say, do it. And then sit back, relax, grab a cup of coffee, because the automation is running in the background. Pretty soon, we're gonna see that SmartSuite is able to find the records with the checked boxes and start erasing them. I'm gonna keep the camera rolling so that we see actually how long it takes while this action is being performed. So let's go ahead and see. It looks like some are already starting to come off. So let's go, oh, there we go, more and more and more. So there we go. So our automation took a few seconds to run, but we see that it did correctly perform the function or the feature that we needed. And of course, we can also go back to app two and see that the trigger has been reverted back to don't do it because the automation has been performed. Now, I also want to point out, nice little bonus that came out from SmartSuite recently, that we can actually drill into this automation and look at the history of the automation runs. So here I am, I see that the automation was started on this day at this time. We had a successful run, it took this long, and it performed this many actions. Now, the thing that I really love about this is that SmartSuite has kept it so, so simple. They didn't have to overcomplicate the way that we build this automation. Obviously, everything that we found in our search feature here, our search action, is something that we want to update. There's no complex looping that we have to take care of or anything like that. It's all there, just put together really nicely and easy to use for anybody who is new to automations. Take this out for a spin and try it out yourself. Of course, I realize we went a little fast here, so if you have questions, feel free to drop them below this video and I'll do my best to answer. And of course, if you haven't already subscribed to this channel and you want to stay up on top of no-code news just like this, you should probably consider hitting that subscribe button. That's it for this one. Thanks so much. In the meantime, keep on building. I want to... For real. I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. I'm in my head now. I feel like you guys are judging me.